game of checkers a little boy and girl had played in weeks, because they'd been busy rehearsing their church's Easter pageant. They were in the scene where Jesus entered Jerusalem with crowds shouting, "Hosanna," and "King of Kings." Now, as the boy slid one checker to the opposite side of the board, he ordered his sister, "They crown me King of Kings." That's really how many of us live. Oh, we never say it out loud, but we want to wear the crown and to rule over our own world. It comes so naturally to live like it's all about us. Even on the morning Jesus rode into the city, the very crowds waving palm branches and praising him had no real understanding of the kind of king whose arrival they were celebrating.
Simply follows the example Jesus said. Thank you.
if there were no one else in the world to love. Because he loved us, he was willing to die to save us. And all we have to do to receive this wonderful gift is ask. The first time someone tells us this story seems too unbelievable to be true. And even when you have been one of his followers for many years, the whole concept of grace is still hard to imagine. We don't have to die eternally because Jesus willingly, lovingly died in our place. And we can live forever because after 3 days, Jesus rose to life again.
He's alive.
words of the 10th verse rang out, the dying man exclaimed, by the grace of God, I am what I am. I'm not what I ought to be. I'm not what I wish to be. I'm not what I hope to be soon. I truly say that I am not what I once was, a slave to sin and Satan. What have you been? A merchant seaman who became a hardened infidel. A man who had been the victim of violence and who had willingly used violence against others. A vicious slave trader who had sunk so low he himself had been a slave. A captain hated by his crew and known among sailors as the great blasphemer. He degraded others, and he himself sank to the depth of human degradation. Yet God found him and saved him. He was a writer of hymns that have touched people for centuries. The story of John Newton's life makes it no surprise that he wrote, Amazing Grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. This gift of grace that God offers every person is incomprehensible. It's beautiful and awe-inspiring, and best of all, it's free. That's why there's really only one word that can describe it. Amazing Grace is about the complete change only God can bring to a person. Once you have truly experienced grace, you never tire of singing about how incredible it is. You want to fall in worship at the feet of Jesus and proclaim that He and He alone is worthy of honor and praise.